The senior barbers or the pioneers of the hairdressing, the hair cutters, is basically to teach what is a good haircut or what is not a good haircut. Like, it's like an art, but some people appreciate the details, appreciate the services. So I think the big part of senior barbers is to keep teaching the new generation to have cutting the right way, the perfect way to treat your customers, treat your clients, treat your patrons, and give the best haircut to every man. Yeah.
Jadi kalau misalkan kalian udah pernah lihat vlog kita sebelumnya, kalau kita ke Singapura, pasti kita mengunjungi barbershop ini. Dan barbershop ini juga yang barengan sama kita waktu itu ke Rusia. Tebak apa?
Udah sering banget. Yang paling sering adalah Bapak Kapiten.
Maksudnya? Sama Kapten kita. Jadi spesial banget hari ini tim TJR datang, bukan hanya kapten aja, kapten
jenderalnya juga.
Jenderalnya juga datang.
Tapi jenderalnya lagi masuk angin. Lagi.
Waduh.
Enak, enak bos.
Enak.
Jadi tim TJR lagi ada di
Jakarta,
lagi di Jakarta, ada di Chief. Spesial banget karena besok kita akan ada satu sesi learning session, karena sebenarnya kita udah sering ketemu sama tim TJR, tapi mereka masih belum mau berbagi nih rahasia-rahasianya. Jadi besok mereka share semuanya. Yanto dan Kapten ada di sini. Mau ngapain aja?
Bumbu-bumbu dapur, resep, dan semua yang berhubungan dengan kiat-kiat yang mereka bisa bagi, mereka akan bagi. Juga Ilham akan berbagi mengenai pengalamannya kemarin di Johor Baru soal fast food.
Iya.
Essential skills buat mereka
sih. Mungkin buat kalian yang belum tahu atau siapa sih tim TJR, lo bisa cek ke Instagramnya apa? The Golden Rules
Barbeco.
Barbeco. The Golden Rules Barbeco. Ada juga Kapten.
Captain's Barber.
Captain's Barber. Kemudian Yanto _ Sani ya. Mm-hmm. Yanto _ Sani. Lo kesana dulu deh sebelum nonton vlog ini, biar lo tahu siapa sih mereka-mereka ini, siapa sih The Golden Rules. Lo cek, lo follow Instagram mereka.
Hasil kerjanya juga gimana, juga ada fotonya, galerinya, Instagramnya, keren-keren. Habis itu baru the next day.
Yeah. So, kita akan mulai sekitar 30 menit lagi.
So, aku rasa aku menang karena I give every single thing. From hair drying, blow drying, styling, fading, shaping, like overall.
Ini look and learn. Jadi kalau ini teknik yang ditunjukkan adalah dari Yanto, dari aku. Mungkin kalian semua sudah tahu atau tahu sama. So, apa yang Yanto buat ini sekarang adalah buat guy nine. So, dia diletak dulu. Ditapakkan, make the guideline.
Okay, my name is Yanto Sani. I'm the owner of the Goruru Barber Company. So basically, I'm a barber and also a business owner. And basically, the Goruru has been around for like 5 years now, almost 5 years. I've been cutting since like 12 years ago. When it all started, I was a hairdresser first before being a barber. Because di Singapore, enggak ada barber school dahulu. So I have to go to a hairdressing school, which is, I think, it helps me to become a better hair cutter. It helps me to use a better scissors work. And after 5 years being hairdresser, then I started to be more into men's only. So that's where I started to become like a full-time classic, traditional barbering.
Sekarang Yanto menggunakan sapa nombor 2, dibuka penuh. Terus.
For what I see in Singapore, there's a huge difference, but it's the same kind of a vibe where the new wave barbershop is spreading around the region. I believe it was like 2008 or 2009. There was like really huge demand of guys wanted to go to barbershop only, not salon, not unisex, because I think it's the whole vibe, the whole masculine, the whole manhood, and that's where the trend becomes really boom. worldwide, like from Europe to Asia, to even to South Africa. So what I see based on like Indonesia and Singapore, the difference is just the price range. And the barbers in Indonesia and the barbers in Singapore is similar, kind of similar, but they have different techniques also based on equipments, based on product styling, and based on the demand of the client, what kind of hairstyle they wanted. So at first there was like really huge into, everyone was into classic. Everyone want to have the slick back look, the pompadours. Basically in Singapore also the same, everyone going for the classic look. But lately in the year of 2016, we have seen a lot of growth of which is the contemporary haircuts and classic. We combine into like a sophisticated look, but it seems like edgy. Like they wanted it to be more natural, more, you know, like a bit Sunday look. So that's the difference right now we can see in 2016 onwards based on Indonesian and Singapore or Malaysia demands. Barbershop, I think Indonesia have like really nice layout, look, design. They have really good designers, they have really good interior designs, educators. I can see a lot of workshop. The demand of education in barbering is really on the rise in Indonesia, especially because I think Indonesia is quite one of the biggest country in Southeast Asia.
So if it's a number one fade, a zero fade, yang penting yang paling bawah, nombor yang paling bawah itu harus bersih.
For me, I think the senior barbers or the pioneers of the hairdressing, like haircutters, is basically to teach what is a good haircut or what is not a good haircut. Like it's like an art, but some people appreciate the details, appreciate the services. So I think the big part of senior barbers is to keep teaching the new generation to have cutting the right way, the perfect way to treat your customers, treat your clients, treat your patrons, and give the best haircut to every man. I think it's very important for our senior barbers or senior stylists to keep passing the education, to keep passing the skills or everything what they have learned throughout the whole experience, like 12 years or 13 years or 20 years. So every day there's something to learn. Even I keep learning. You cannot stop learning. There's always new techniques, there's always something that we can learn from someone. Even though they are not haircutters or hair barbers, like you can learn something from everyone. So we have to keep on learning, like what can I progress, what can I give you, like provide a better service, you know. Is my chair comfortable, is the aircon cool enough? Everything plays a part. So the senior stylists or the senior barbers need to keep up passing to the new generation.
Hadiahnya akan didapat super taper. Dan selain itu hadiah spesial dari Golden Rule, dari kita dari Singapura, kita akan kirim
over. Doesn't matter how many likes or how many followers you have on Instagram or how many shops you have, but I think the most important thing is to be humble as a barber or hairstylist, because you're giving service to clients, you're giving treatment to almost like a doctor or a tailor. You know, you don't want to have like a snobbish doctor treating you. You know, you want to feel good at all times. So every visit for a customer is you have to give the best treatment. So always be humble, down to earth, and give the best to your clients. Two is always keep learning, keep watching, keep traveling. Go to other barbershops, go meet a lot of haircutters, make friends, and never stop learning from everyone. Like you can learn, like your neighbors, you know, you have other neighbors, you know, like what kind of products you're using, what kind of tools you're using now. You always can try out. Don't be scared to try something new or learn or ask to somebody, even though you think that I think I'm good enough, but just keep on learning. That's important for me, like, because the learning never stops.
Feelingnya enggak ada apa-apa masalah. Feeling memang bersih. Chief memang feeling bagus.
So the last one is the service, which is mostly barbershop forgets about the service, which is they always think about I have the best haircutting skills or the best fades. Mostly it's 70% service, 30% is the skills, which is your clients are paying your bills actually. So you need to keep having your clients sitting on your chair. So 70% service, don't forget about it, other than just skills.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5!